Hello, I'm Dr. Wendy Bridges. Are you confused about what length or type of appointment to make with your GP? It is a common cause of frustration for patients and with GPs. I'm going to try and share a little bit of information to make this a little bit easier. If you have one problem that needs dealing with, then what you want is a regular appointment. So an example of this is if you have a sick toddler that needs checking out, if you're on contraception and you need a repeat script, if you want to talk about what sort of contraception is right for you, if you need a repeat script for your blood pressure medication and your blood pressure checking, that's a regular appointment. If you have more than one problem or a problem that's going to take a bit longer, then what you really need is a long appointment. So a long appointment is, if you want to talk about menopause, what are your options, and you need a pap smear, long appointment. If you need to talk about how your diabetes is going and how your blood pressure is going and get quite a few scripts, long appointment. If you want to talk about your mental health and you need a skin check, long appointment. If you specifically need a mental health care plan, that's a different kind of appointment. Let the receptionist know you're going to need at least 20 minutes and probably longer to do that one. Very rarely does anything get sorted out in a short appointment in general practice. People are often surprised and frustrated by this. They're like, I just wanted a script, I just wanted a referral. How is this a standard appointment and not a short appointment? Let me tell you from a GP's point of view, what we're going through when we're asked to provide you with a script or a referral. If you're coming in for a script, I need to make sure that this medication still suits you now and is the best choice for you now, as opposed to when somebody started you on it. How's it suiting you? Are you taking it? What sort of side effects have you got? Is there something better out there? I'm going through all this stuff before I give you another script. Same with referrals. We are obliged to collect as much information as we can about the problem that you have, order any tests or organise any tests that you might need to have, really think about who's going to be the best person or procedure or situation for you to be referred to, get all that information together and send that referral off. As you can see, that's not a 5-minute job, so it's going to be probably more like a standard appointment. So my advice is to be on the safe side, always book a standard appointment. If it really does turn out to be something very simple, your doctor can always bill you less. But at least if you book a standard appointment, both you and your doctor will be prepared to take the time that's actually needed to do things properly and get what you were hoping to achieve when you came to the doctor done. I'm Dr. Wendy Bridges. If you need health information from a reliable source, I'm a GP. Subscribe to my channel.